What's up, guys? It's Coach Drew, and today I'm going to take you guys through a shooting warm-up that all my NBA players do. It gets you ready to knock down shots in workouts, and ultimately, if you do it before games, it'll help you knock down more shots in games because you'll develop a consistent routine, which will help you become more of a consistent shooter, which obviously is what we want in games. So the first thing that you want to do is you always want to start close to the basket, do some kind of form shooting because we want to make sure that we just get good touch, have a good feel of the ball. So the first thing I do is we always just stand underneath the hoop and just get a bunch of swishes. So we're just trying to shoot this ball and just get it over the rim and swish it. And again, we'll try to make five of them. And once we make five of them, then we can move back. So you see right there, five swishes, and then we move back. Now we can do it from multiple ranges. So normally I would do it from right here, same exact thing, swish five, and then I go back here and swish five. But for the sake of time, you guys would just go ahead and swish five from three different ranges. The next thing we do, now that we've got good touch, we've got a good feel for the ball, just getting loose, getting confident, we like to see the ball go in. The next thing that we want to do is now we want to work on kind of different pickups. So many times when we catch the ball outside our frame or we're stuffing the ball, that's what really messes us up. So now what we'll do is we'll do a simple drill where if I'm a right-hand shooter, my right hand's ready, the left hand has the ball, and we're just going to stuff the ball at the same time. So foot happens at the same time as the stuff, and then we shoot it from there. So right there, we just go ahead and shoot it. Again, we catch it with two, we go here, stuff, and shoot it, and we're gonna try to make five of those right there with stuffing it and then shooting it. We would do the exact same thing with our right hand, left foot back, where now what we do is we don't ever wanna stuff. So if I'm a right-hand shooter, we don't wanna stuff it and then bring our right hand across our body. What we'd wanna do is we wanna bring our left hand to our right hand and then shoot. So right here, notice that I flipped the ball over right there, I flip it over and then shoot it because we never want our right hand, if we're a right-hand shooter, to come across our body. That'll lead to kind of side flings and we want a straight shot every single time. So again, first thing we do in front of the rim, five swishes, then mid-range kind of five swishes right here. Then we've got five stuffs. Right now we've already made 25 shots. We've seen the ball go through the rim 25 times. We're feeling really good. Next thing we'll do is we'll hop down and basically get our rhythm and then make sure we're shooting our shots. So I'm right here, I pop down, I jump up, I shoot. Again, right here, get the ball, I pop down, rhythm, up, and shoot. Again, you're trying to make five of those. So now not only have we seen the ball go through the rim, you know, 30 times, now what we're doing is we have rhythm, we have a good feel, we're getting good high arc, we're making sure it's straight every single time, and we have good pickups as well from the stuff drills. Then we need to work on basically that good pickup off the dribble because we're gonna have to shoot shots off the dribble in the game. So now our feet again are right where we want them. We're gonna dribble down, same thing. Since we added rhythm with the last drill, we don't wanna lose that. So we go down with the dribble, stuff, and then shoot. So we basically incorporate the last two drills that we did together. So I go dribble, drop down, up, shoot. So I'm right here, drop down, up, shoot right there, knock it down. And again, one more, I'm right here, drop down, up, and shoot. And again, make as many as I can. I'm trying to make five with as little shot attempts as I can. Then I would do the exact same thing right here. Again, when I stuff it, I'm not going over here and bringing it over here. I would dribble, keep that ball on my right side, and do the exact same thing. So now again, we've got our shot pocket. We've got different pickups. We've got good rhythm. Then we start working on a couple game-like shots. And so really in the game, there's only kind of five dribbles that we can really do. So we're gonna work on those five shots off the dribble, then we're gonna work on a couple different footwork things so we have everything that we really need, and then we'll be ready to knock down more shots. So the first one off the dribble that we need to have is just off a hezzy. So now I'm gonna dribble, let the ball hang, I'm gonna step one, two, again, stuff the ball over, and then shoot it. So dribble, hezzy, bang, stuff it, and shoot. Again, one more time, I'm dribbling, let the ball hang, stuff, shoot. You can add a little rhythm with your shoulders if you want to. That'll help you out with the move. But the most important thing is the stuff. And then we do it again on our right hand as well, the exact same thing. After we got the hang and the hezzy, basically, then we go to a crossover. On the crossover, again, we just want the ball to change from one hand to the next. So again, I'm right here. I'm dribbling. I cross the ball over and again, stuff it. It doesn't matter how your feet are. So you could go crossover, hop. You could go crossover, one, two. You could go crossover, one, two this way. It doesn't really matter. We just want the ball floating from one hand to the next and then ultimately go up and knock it down. We'd make five of those in each direction as well. The next thing you wanna do is you wanna go between the legs. Okay, since I've been demonstrating going to the left, this time I'll demonstrate with the ball going to the right. But again, between the legs, up and shoot it. Okay, the exact same thing right here, dribbling between the legs, up and shoot it. That'll allow us to really get a good pickup off the between the legs. Then we have to go behind the back. So now I'm here, dribble, again, pop up and shoot. And then one more time, dribble, bang, and pop up and shoot. Again, you wanna work on different things. We've got the hang, we've got the crossover, we've got the between the legs, the behind the back, and the last one that we have is making sure we do some kind of step back or sidestep so that the ball is way outside our frame and then comes back in our frame. So it's in right there, get good pickups, and then we can go the other way, or we can do, you know, all five right there and work on our pickups. After we got all those off the dribble, and again, we still didn't work on pullbacks, we didn't work on kind of different things that we can do in a game, but we worked on the main ones, then we work off the catch. And so off the catch, what we'll need is we'll need to basically have a 1-2 pivot. So right here, we turn and shoot. Again, right here, turn and shoot. Then what we'll need to have is we'll need to have a hop. So now what I'm gonna do is on this, I'm gonna hop, turn and shoot. Again, right here, hop, turn and shoot. And then the last one that we'll need to have is we'll need to make sure that we have something, and again, it doesn't have to be perfect, but some kind of reverse pivot so we can work on that. And so if the passer's here, it doesn't really matter. I'm gonna do it from this angle, but basically when I catch the ball, I wanna go backwards and shoot. And the reason we do this is because so many times what happens in a game is if we go backwards, our momentum goes backwards and we wanna just stay forward. Again, there's a ton of different variations of shots that you can do, but if you work on those, whether it's you take it really seriously and make five of each, or whether you boil it down to making a couple of each one, two to three, if you do those, you'll prime yourself for a big game because you'll be consistent with your habits, ultimately getting a consistent routine, and then you'll be consistent when it comes game time to knock down shots.